hypothalamic amenorrhea, so HA, a lacking of a period for 3 months or longer. Before I get started on this video, I just want to say if you have any health concerns at all, make sure you speak to your doctor. And second of all, this is my YouTube channel. It is my personal journey. I'm making this video in hope that it, one, raises the awareness of the importance of having a regular cycle, and two, that hopefully maybe my journey kind of resembles something similar to yours, so that maybe these tips might help you. But of course, it's just what I did, and every single person is different. So let's get started. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am just going to dive straight into this chit chat. Dad, if you are watching this, this YouTube video is not for you. So this one is going to be on a very personal topic I did not think I would talk about publicly, but I realized after posting on Instagram how many of you really need this and how important it is to be open about it and talk about it, because it is a part of my journey, and I started social media sharing my journey, and that's what I'm going to continue to do. So without further ado, let's get started on the topic of periods. I assume that if you are watching this video and you're searching up how to get your period back, then you're probably already switched on to how important it is to have a regular cycle. If not, I actually did a post on Instagram. You can pause and have a read of this. I talked all about the kind of side effects of disrupted hormones, and essentially if your body is not producing a monthly cycle, something is wrong. There is something not quite right there, and this means that you need to look and reflect on what you're doing in your everyday life in order to take care of your body from the inside out. So for me personally, whenever I lean down to 20% or below, that seems to be when mine will stop. This happens when I prepare for a competition. It even happened this year when I did a mini shred at the end of January. So at the end of January, I started a shred. It was only about 6 weeks, and then I found out that my competition wasn't going to be happening, but I'd already lost it. I realized then I wasn't going to be doing a competition, and we were going into lockdown. I was kind of a little bit obsessed with not gaining the weight back. I really didn't want to gain any weight during lockdown because I didn't have gym. I just thought it would be kind of pointless weight gain as I wasn't able to build enough muscle with the weights that we had at home. So I ended up getting a little bit obsessed with the scale and staying the same weight, and I managed to do it the whole way through lockdown. I stayed the exact same weight, but I thought me not getting my period back was due to the stress of being on lockdown with Ross's family, being out of our usual routine, and I just put it down to that. I thought, you know what, it'll come back after lockdown. Fast forward, coming out of lockdown, it didn't come back. I was still the same weight, and then I was going into the gym and doing weight training as well, and I was still hitting my steps every single day, and things just weren't working for me. I felt like emotionally quite off. I couldn't really, I don't know, I just didn't feel quite right. Without having it, I didn't feel healthy, because I know that it's a vital sign of a healthy female body. So I ended up cutting out caffeine on June 1, so I've been caffeine free since then. It's now the end of July. I worked on cutting back some of my stresses, so caffeine is a stressor, that's why I cut that back. My workouts went down to 5 days a week, so I currently have 5 weight training sessions in the gym, 2 rest days, and I'm aiming to currently only do 6,000 steps a day. Some days, of course, it's gonna be more, but this is just what I needed to do. So, of course, usually I would do my 10,000 steps a day, I'd do my weight training, but I just needed to take things back down and really just look at what I'm doing with my training, because I wanted to be doing weight training, and I know I've had it when I do weight train, so I wasn't gonna cut that out, but I did cut back my cardio, so no extra cardio on top of my weight training. And then cutting back my steps in the past week or two, I cut them down to 6,000 from around 8,000 to 10,000. So following on from that, I also ended up increasing my weight. I just realized that, yes, of course, it was really cool that I stayed the same weight during lockdown. That's great. But my body obviously wasn't loving it, sitting around 20% body fat. It's winter right now. I'm not wearing a bikini anytime soon. I don't have photo shoots, video shoots, or fitness expos anytime soon. So I thought, you know what, I may as well see what happens and increase my weight. So I ended up gaining 4 to 5 kilos. and my body seems to be a lot happier. It has been a big mental game to see the scale weight go up, to be like a lot, I guess, less lean than I usually am, especially with my social media growing. I feel like there's a lot of eyes on me, especially with my fit with Anjuli and Anjuli Fit Squad. I don't ever want anyone following my journey and think, oh, she's not inspirational because she's not lean, she doesn't have abs. Like, you really have to focus on your overall health, and that's the most important thing. I never started my fitness journey to have abs. I started it to be healthy, and this was something I needed to do for me regardless of what anyone else around me thought. So I had to really try and tune out everyone else's opinions of me and just do what I knew was best, and it helped having Ross support me the whole way through. I honestly just love that he loves me no matter what. So anyway, I gained some weight. I cut back my training to 5 days a week instead of 6 days a week. I cut back my daily steps. I cut out all caffeine, so no pre-workouts or anything. I also, following on from that, increased my sleep quality, I guess, because I wasn't having any caffeine. So I always aim for 8 hours of sleep a night, and I try and wind down before bed, whether that is to read a book before bed or to journal. Journaling was another thing I started doing. I kind of journaled how I feel, maybe like once a week, just to help offload things from my head. And then following on from that, something I haven't really talked about publicly is sometimes I, you know what, like to go to a therapist. And so I started going back to my therapist a few weeks ago, and I've been to her twice now, and I'll go to her again this week and next week. And the reason for this is I had actually watched lots of other YouTube videos and read a lot online, and they said that speaking to a therapist can really help because it can help take off your mental stress. So I'm a chronic like overthinker. I overthink everything. I have a lot going on in my mind about business, my relationship with Ross, my friendships, and just everything is always in my head. And so by going to a therapist and talking to her about competing, my past with my relationship with food and everything like that, it just helped me kind of get a lot off my chest, so that I guess the mental energy was taken out of everything that was happening in my head. So speaking to a therapist has definitely done wonders for me, especially in regards to the weight gain side of things. Like, she just reminded me that I am so, so much more than how I look on the outside. And let's be honest, like, superficial looks only last for so long. You have to be more than that, and I am so much more than how I look on the outside. So it was nice just to have someone reassuring me that I was doing the right thing, and I was, and I am so happy now that I've done what I've done in order to get to where I am. Other things to help with stress, I also went to physio once a week for a while. I've kind of stopped now, it gets a little bit expensive, but he also gave me acupuncture once. I heard that acupuncture can be really good for the hormones. I did it once and that was all, but if you know, have the ability to be able to go to get acupuncture weekly or whatever, then of course that could help. Another thing I also did when I wasn't going to physio, I would go to get a massage once a week, like an hour relaxing massage, just to help again with those stress levels. So a few key things there: sleep, physio or massages, and cutting back the stress in any way I could, along with speaking to a therapist or even just speaking to a loved one about how you're feeling, if you're feeling a little bit emotionally drained, which is totally understandable during 2020 because it has been a crazy year. Another thing I did was, it wasn't just increasing my calories. I actually tried increasing my calories and I gained the 4 to 5 kilos, but I still hadn't got it back. So in the past 2 weeks, I actually ended up taking down my protein intake, taking down my fat intake a little bit, and increasing my carbs. So a lot of videos and websites and things like that will tell you to increase your fats. And of course, fats are so important for our hormone production, but so are carbs. And so what I thought I would do is try taking back my fats a little bit and increasing my carbs. And the carbs have done wonders for me to fuel me through my workouts. I hit 130 kilo deadlift last week and I'm just so much stronger. I feel so much more in control with my food being on higher carbs, and it's just helping me, I guess, get through my workouts, and my body obviously doesn't feel like it's too hungry now, and that's at 2000 calories. So I've cut my calories down from what they were already when I increased the weight, and now my main goal is just to kind of like maintain this weight at 2000 calories. And if it starts to come down, that's fine with me. I'm not gonna rush into a shred. I'm not gonna try and gain any more weight. I'm really happy with where I am. I just wanna keep things constant so that come next month, hopefully, fingers crossed, everything goes to plan and it just keeps coming regularly. So yeah, that's kind of everything I wanted to talk about. The key things, I guess, it's just really taking time to, one, realize that it is important to have a regular cycle. Two, know that just because a lot of people lose their periods with their competing or training and their dieting and things like that, doesn't mean it's normal. It might be common, but it's not normal. It's a lie that you should be okay with losing your period during your weight training or your fitness journey. Because in reality, like, there are people that are able to comp prep, step on stage and still have their period because their bodies aren't under stress, whereas there's other people like me and mine just disappears the second I start getting leaner. Everyone is different and it's important not to compare yourself to anyone else or your journey to anyone else. This applies to so many different things in life. Three, make sure you speak to a doctor. Get your hormones tested if you can and you have the ability to do so. I didn't because I'd already had my hormones tested last year. It's super expensive. And I kind of knew that if I just did what I've done in the past, like increasing weight, increasing calories, and taking care of myself, it would come back anyway. This was a really random chit chat, but I just know how important it is to raise the awareness of this. And I hope that some of these tips in this video help you. If you have been trying for a while to get yours back and it's just not showing up, just know that you are not alone. Keep trusting the process. Keep working hard on getting it back. Don't fixate on it too much because you'll just increase your stress levels around that. Just kind of like forget about it if you can and just keep ticking off things daily, like reducing your stress, journaling, maybe seeing a therapist or talking to someone about it, increasing your calories, eating more food, and it will come eventually. Like, your body will get to a point where it's ready to, you know, get regulating things again. So I really just wanted to have an honest chit chat with you. Very simple. It's just what worked for me. It may or may not work for you. Hopefully something from this is something that you can apply to your life in general anyway. Like, speaking to a therapist is not something to be ashamed of. Writing in a journal is good for offloading your mental thoughts anyway. Speaking to a loved one about how you're feeling in general is always going to be a good idea. And then, you know what, maybe at times it's just important that you take time to go get a massage, or you increase your calories, you stop focusing on fat loss all the time and stressing over that, and you just focus on getting your calories up, building some muscle, and enjoying a fitness journey without having to worry about whether or not you have a six pack, because you are so much more than your external features. So if you're someone that has been in a really downward spiral of continuously trying to lose weight or so scared of gaining weight, I just want to remind you that you're so much more than that, and you have to focus on your overall health. If that means that you have to gain a few kilos in order to be healthy, like, who cares? It's just a few kilos. So yeah, mine was gone for 4.5 months and it's back now. Fingers crossed it stays that way, but I'm in no rush to shred down anytime soon. We'll just see what happens, and I hope that you have an incredible day or night ahead. Please feel free to message me anytime or comment on this video if you have any tips that have helped you get yours back, or if you're trying anything new. I'm sure others would love to learn from you as well. Bye.